welcome to Chris's Chaos. I am your host, Chris Cortez, and today we are going to cover predictions for two events coming up. We got the AEW Wrestle Dream that will be taking place tonight at 8 o'clock Eastern Time from Seattle, Washington. We also have the Road to Destruction, Saturday, October 7th, and that will take place this Saturday, October 7th. For the most part, I think I know that most of us are looking forward to tonight's event and the card, so I want to cover that first. We'll do predictions, and we'll talk a little bit about it. The other thing we're going to then we'll carry on over into Road to Destruction. So for those of you that want to stick around for that, you can stick around for that as well. It's been a minute since I've recorded. So if you don't remember, please hit that subscribe button at Channel Cortez 33 for both Instagram and Twitter. And yes, sometimes guys, you got to take time off for yourself. You got to make sure that you do what you need to do with your friends, your family members, your significant other, your wife, your husband. And those are the things I've been doing for the last few weeks. I recently came back from a trip from Hawaii. Yes, I was staying in Oahu, and I got my little coffee mug from Hawaii. And yes, you pronounce it Hawaii with the W being a V sound. Just learned that. Did some surfing, did some snorkeling, did some hiking, and did a little trip through Koala Ranch. If you ever, you know, wanted to know where Jurassic World's, Jumanji, the one with the rock, and Kong Skull Island was recorded, head out to Koala Ranch. Now, we're going to cover focus on Road to Destruction and, of course, Wrestle Dream. We're going to watch Wrestle Dream tonight. We will all be watching it. And then this week, I'm looking for Monday, Tuesday to work with my good buddy Jonathan at Bad Guy Wrestling, who recently celebrated a birthday. His birthday was earlier in September, but we just went ahead and did a little surprise dinner party for him at good old Maggiano's. Gotta love some Maggiano's. So that was last night, and I know he's looking forward to watching the show tonight. We'll do our little review, just how our thoughts on it, and I will carry on forward. I don't think I'll be able to just immediately do a review of October 7th's show. That's why I want to cover it. I'm going to go to a wedding in Pittsburgh. Got to cover that. So there's just a lot going on. This is that time of year. Not to mention, I got a full-time job teaching. It's first quarter. It is a very busy time. I wanted to get a review in of some of the content that I had watched for New Japan on the Road to Destruction, but wasn't able to really successfully get it all in. Been very tired. So, you know, we're going on fumes here. But now we're here. We have some time. We're going to cover some predictions. We're going to talk about Wrestle Dream. So right into it, I'm going to go ahead and talk about Wrestle Dream taking place tonight, 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Of course, taking place in Seattle. So yeah, it's good. If it's starting at 8 o'clock, it's going to be about 5 o'clock there. It's going to be daytime. Well, you know, evening time. So let's cover this show, okay? Now, the match that like really got me sold on this pay-per-view, okay? There's only one, and I think you know which one it is. Okay, because quite frankly, you know I'm a New Japan Pro Wrestling guy. I want to see Bryan Danielson versus Zack Sabre Jr., okay? That match, I'm telling you, Bryan Danielson should lose to Zack Sabre. Zack Sabre has so much more going for him early. Like, he's so, like, young in his career right now compared to a Bryan Danielson. Danielson has been tearing apart different guys from New Japan. Talk about beating Okada, okay? He's beaten who did he just recently beat in AEW? He defeated Ricky Starks. He needs taken out. But I could, you know, knowing what's going on with AEW and how high everybody is on Bryan Danielson, I wouldn't be surprised if Danielson wins. But I'm rooting for Zack Sabre on this. I love Bryan Danielson. I think he's so entertaining. He, as you know, has that attitude. But honestly, the Blackpool Combat Club has been taking a lot of hits. They recently lost the ROH Heavyweight Championship. Claudio lost it to Eddie Kingston. You got Jon Moxley losing to Rey Fénix in what was a pretty underwhelming title match, okay, that really had a botched kind of finish. I don't know what was going on with that. You guys can help me out here in the comments section and tell me a little bit what's going on with that. All I know is that was a big misfire. Like, they should not have dropped the title so soon. We're talking about a guy who had just recently defeated, okay, Orange Cassidy, who had held the title for how many matches, how many defeats that he had, how many wins to only lose it to John Moxley, who should have carried it a little bit longer to set up for the next up-and-coming winner. Okay, Rey Fénix. He's a great guy to win. Do I think Rey Fénix could win that title and beat John Moxley? Sure. But there should have been a build-up for that match. There should have been much more of a build-up for that match. So now you got a Rey Fénix winning the title, and everybody's like, well, the casual audience would be like, well, who's this guy? I mean, he's coming out of nowhere. So they botched. They misfired. They jumped the gun on this. They pulled the trigger way too soon. Not sure what's going on. Probably something going on behind the scenes. John Moxley might have to take a break. Okay. Well, either way, it was. It's a little sad that's what had to happen. So, likewise, we have, Ring of Honor, Claudio Castagnoli losing to Eddie Kingston. That I'm okay with. That there was a build. Eddie Kingston, it looks like he's going to eventually drop his New Japan, a strong open weight championship. He's probably going to drop that title to Nari. That's what I'm seeing. So I'm okay with what happened with him. Now you got Bryan Danielson. Is he going to lose to Zack Sabre? I think Zack Sabre needs the win. He's the New Japan Pro Wrestling Television champion. He's the guy that he has a lot more to lose right now. So that's where I'm going with. I want to see Zack Sabre win. I could foresee Danielson winning, but I'm going to stick with Zack Sabre. It makes the most sense to me. Then you got Hangman Adam Page versus Swerve Strickland. Okay. Again, this is another match that needs. Swerve is the one on the rise. Swerve's the one that has more to grow, needs more. He's got more at stake because he needs build. This guy has looked great. He's put in a lot of work, and he seems to kind of like lose at the very end. And like just when you think he's going to kind of take it to the next step, he loses. This could be a match to kind of take him to another level. He needs to beat Adam Page. That is my prediction. He should beat Adam Page. That's all I'm saying. It could go either way, but I'm going for Swerve Strickland. Makes the most sense. FTR versus Awesome Aussie Open, AEW Tag Team Championships. All right, this is great. FTR hasn't done much with the titles. I mean, other than having like some dream matches with Bullet Club Gold and the Young Bucks. Okay, they could have a great segment with Aussie Open. I think Aussie Open could take the titles right now and become the next big tag team. Put them on the map. Talk about having outsider AEW competitors coming in to take over. I think Aussie Open should win this. They dropped the titles to MJF and Adam Cole. They took the L in front of 80,000 plus. I mean, they deserve to win against FTR and be recognized as one of the, if not the top tag title champion, tag champions or tag team wrestling factions in the business. I think Aussie Open should take it. So, pardon me, but yes, Aussie Open. I'm going with Aussie Open. FTR, if they win, I'm not going to cry about it. I think FTR is a good bet to win, but I'm going to go with Aussie Open on this. So there you go. MJF, champion versus the Righteous 2-on-1 handicap match for the ROH World Tag Team Championships. This is kind of not much build for me. I think that MJF, if he somehow pulls a victory, okay. But then again, if Righteous wins, I don't know too much about that. If they win, basically because MJF is on his own and Adam Cole's not helping enough, this is a very odd situation they've put MJF in. So I could see it go either way. I'm going to go with MJF just kind of holding on, somehow miraculously winning, holding on to his tag title championships with Adam Cole until there's like a definitive loss where a tag team beats both Adam Cole and MJF. That's just where I'm going to go with it. Chris Jericho and the Golden Lovers. Okay, versus Kenny Omega, Kota Ibushi, right? Versus the Don Callis family, Konosuke Takeshita, Sammy Guevara, Will Ospreay. This is a great group of guys. Talk about like six awesome competitors, okay? Yeah. Are we going to keep it going? Sure. This could go either way. I think that Jericho could use a win. Kenny Omega as well and Kota Ibushi, they've kind of been on the receiving end of some losses. So maybe they need a win to kind of keep them afloat. However, Takeshita, Guevara, and Ospreay are looking so strong, and maybe they need more of the momentum going to really establish this Don Callis family, which is what's happening. You have a Don Callis family being built up. And I think Guevara is kind of a great addition to the family, the faction. Meanwhile, you got Ospreay, who's still the leader of the United Empire. I mean, the United Empire is not a part of the Don Callis family. So This is very, very odd faction that kind of goes inter promotional, kind of a route, show. Yeah, I could see Don Callis' family winning. All right, so that's just where I'm going to go with it. It could go either way. Got Christian Cage versus Darby Allin, 2 out of 3 falls match for the AEW TNT Championship. Not even Cage's title. He's defending it. If he wins, that would make some sense because I kind of feel like it needs to end with Luchasaurus defeating Christian Cage. And something is so off here with Christian Cage. I mean, I love it. I love that he's holding that title. But what is going to happen is at some point, there's got to be some sort of dispute between Cage and Luchasaurus. Maybe this starts it. Maybe Darby does win. He totally could deserve to. I mean, he totally, you know, there's no reason why Darby Allin cannot defeat Christian Cage based on what we've seen from Darby Allin. He's put on some hell, you know, great work throughout this year and deserves to hold a title. However, Christian Cage, that story is kind of still being told. Who knows what's going to happen here? Who knows? Maybe we get an appearance from Edge. I'm hearing that Edge is now AEW bound. That would make sense. I would love to see Darby Allin team up with Edge and Sting. That would make a lot of sense. So going with Cage. Going with Cage over Darby Allin. Eddie Kingston versus Katsuyori Shibata, Ring of Honor Championship and New Japan Strong Championship match. So it sounds to me like this is just, if I'm not mistaken, Shibata's a pure champion. So he's nothing to lose. Kingston's going to win. Is what I'm looking at here. Kingston, this is kind of an easy one. I mean, I like watching me be wrong and Shibata win. I don't see Shibata winning this against Kingston. Kingston just won the title. He's going to defend it for a while. So at least give him a couple weeks, right? So yeah, should be a fun match though. Chris Statlander versus the champion versus Julia Hart, AEW TBS Championship. Statlander has done much with that title. She needs to hold on to it. Julia Hart, would I like to see her win? Yes, I'd like to see her win, put some more gold on the House of Black. But I can see Statlander holding on and retaining the title. So that's where I'm going to go with it. Okay, simple enough. Young Bucks versus the Guns versus the Lucha Brothers versus Orange Cassidy and Hook. Winning team gets a future AEW World Tag Team Championship match. Okay, who deserves this more than anybody? The Lucha Bros. I'm going to give it to the Lucha Bros. I could see Lucha Bros definitely get another title shot. They are such a great tag team. They have a lot of momentum going with Rey Fénix being the ring of the international champion, the AEW international champion. So that would make sense. The Guns, they could win. Are we going to see another Young Bucks vying for the tag titles? Only this time going up against Aussie Open? Could be the case. So it's open. Who knows? Maybe Cassidy and Hook. It's very much open. I'm going to go with the Lucha Bros. I want to see Lucha Bros defeat this, go on to face whoever wins that FTR and Aussie Open match. It's a win-win. So that's just me, okay? Then you got Ricky Starks versus Wheeler Yuta. Starks needs to win. I mean, he just put on a hell of a match against Daniel Bryan. He needs to win. Wheeler Yuta can always take hits. He's kind of the whipping boy for the Blackpool Combat Club. So I'm going with Starks, and that's it. Unless they want to like swerve us and give us a surprise victory for Yuta, great. And maybe they're going to keep this going for a couple more matches. Okay, that makes sense. But Starks, I'm going with Starks versus Yuta. And that's what we got for so far. I'm looking forward to it. I've had a busy week, a tiring week. I'd love nothing more than to just sit back and watch some fresh pro wrestling card. Okay, there's so much wrestling being thrown at us. I'd like to focus in on a card like this. Okay, and just watch and enjoy. Nothing too much at stake here. I just want to see what happens here. This is going to be a lot of fun. Okay, for those of you that want to tune in to my review, stay tuned. We're going to go cover the October 7th Road to Destruction New Japan Pro Wrestling card that's going to take place this Saturday. I will be in Pittsburgh. By the time it shows up, it will be that Saturday. There's no way I'm going to be able to watch this show live or like right after. I'm going to have to watch it on Sunday maybe and then do a little review, my thoughts on this show. But it's going to be a good one. I've been watching some of the other dates leading up to this card. I had to catch up, okay? I recently just checked out the September 30th card, and there's a lot to say that I really enjoy watching to see what's going to happen, particularly the Sonata, the just four guys versus the House of Torture. That segment, that program is, to me, very entertaining. As I expected it to happen. I didn't get to really flush this out. But I knew Sho was going to win that, you know, KOPW title. I had just a feeling that he was like, okay, he's messing with Tai Chi. He's going to walk away with the title. Sonata and Evil. Evil, not so much. Evil's going to drop that. I don't think he's going to take the title from Sonata. That's not going to happen. Eventually, it's going to end with Sonata, okay, reclaiming his belt, okay, his title, because he is still the champion and he has a lot more to prove before he eventually drops the title to the next guy, okay? A lot of stuff, though, here. One of the other things that I was really interested in looking forward to is Hiromu Takahashi versus Mike Bailey versus Lio Rush. And I watched Lio Rush and Kazuchika Okada. Great, great tag team. Duo when they want to work together. Rush and Okada. Rush makes a lot of sense in Chaos. I still kind of miss the new music, the old music for Lio Rush. I'm okay with his new music, but I miss that eerie sound that just kind of gets into the beat. I always thought it was so unique and just so perfect fitting for Lio Rush. But this music is kind of like more like, I want to say, more what you would expect for a song for Lio. Okay, it sounds upbeat, it's got energy, and that's cool. That's fine. But I do like the original music that he was playing throughout the last year and a half. And then you got Tetsuya Naito. He essentially kind of faded to the back. It wasn't really about him. It was more about Hiromu and Lio. Same with Okada. Okada kind of backed up Lio Rush to make sure that Lio would kind of show his dominance, to show that he's definitely a worthy opponent for Hiromu. So this has very much been a fun, setup for that. And Doki, I mean, going back to five guys. Eventually, there's going to be a fill-in. There's going to be a fifth guy. I have a feeling. There are a couple guys that I have in mind. They've already kind of hinted at certain people that's going to take the place of Kanemaru. So it's going to happen. But Doki seems like he's the one that's going to maybe defeat Sho for the KOPW title. We'll see. Okay. And then let's move on forward to October 1st. Let's just take a look at a couple other storylines that are taking place. You got the Bullet Club, okay, the Rebel Club, really feuding with the Guerrillas of Destiny and El Fantasmo, as well as you've got Kevin Knight and Kushida. Yes, there's a lot going on here, and that will be interesting to see. It's going to all, really build up for a David Finlay versus Tama Tonga. That's an inevitable thing that's going to happen. So I look forward to that as well. So moving forward, I still need to check out the October 1st match, that final match of the elimination match where you got the Bullet Club versus the Guerrillas of Destiny. Looks fun. I need to check out that sixth match, 4-on-4, just four guys versus the House of Torture. And as well as the best of series, the best of seven series is really interesting because there is sounds to me like there's a draw taking place between Wado, Umino, and Nagata versus Desperado, Ren, Narita, and Minoru Suzuki. So I'd like to see how that's going to play out. Let's take a look at this card for the seventh. Okay, Saturday, October 7th. You got Yuto Nakashima versus Sonari. Inari's on fire. He's going after that KOPW open title. They're building him up to take it from Kingston. That's what I is foreseen. So I think Inari's going to win. Toriano, Yoshihashi, Hiroki Goto. Two of the guys here are the IWGP champions. They're taking on Callum Newman, Great O'Conn, Jeff Cobb. Newman's great. Okay. I do see United Empire winning this tag match, this three-on-three tag match. Just because I do see that they lost the last couple matches with they need some more momentum. I do think that it would be great to see a Jeff Cobb and Great O'Conn versus Hashi and Goto. Not saying that that's going to be the turn of events, but that would make a good tag team to win. But Hashi and Goto, they can hold on to these titles as long as they need to, because when they drop that title, it's going to be the 100th IWGP Tag Team Champions. Whoever wins that is going to be monumental for this promotion. So let it ride, let it build, and let's see what happens. But I do think United Empire is going to win that little program. Then you got the third match, the best of seven. Match six, You know, Watto, Umino, Nagata. Let's give it to them, because I do think that there needs to be. It's gonna result in a kind of a match seven. You know, where you've got a kind of a tie going on here. It's gonna be. You know, the winner is going to be. Could it end tonight? Sure, but I would like to see this go on a little bit further. All right, to match seven. So that's. I think Watto, Umino, Nagata need to win this match. And then you got. ELP, Hikuleo, Tangaloa versus Drillo Maloney, Clark Connors, Chase Owens. You know there's a little bit of feud going between Loa and Owens, as Owens had that little arm wrestling match on the previous card. It was so funny. I thought that was a very funny moment. I love the way Owens sold the arm wrestling match where he got like slammed back a couple times his arm. He's selling his arm like he just got like hit with a chair, whereas Loa does get hit with a chair by the Bullet Club. Very interesting. It could go either way. I could see Bullet Club winning this just to kind of keep the tension going. But we're going to see a match between Loa and Owens eventually. Then you got Jado, Kevin Knight, Kushida, Tama Tonga versus Gato, Gabe Kidd, Alex Coughlin, and the never open weight champion, David Finlay, the leader of the Bullet Club. Again, maybe going with Tama Tonga on this one, but David Finlay kind of needs to win. So I'm going to go with Bullet Club. I kind of feel like Bullet Club's going to kind of win this night, if you will. They're going to be 2-0. Gorilla Destiny will be 0-2 for this particular night. So let's just see what happens. Then you've got another kind of important match. You got a big match, 4-on-4. 1 second. You got Takemichi Noku, Doki, Taichi, Sanada versus Yoshinobu Kanemaru, Yujiro Takahashi. Okay. Show and Evil. They're going to keep this going until sooner or later, you know, there's going to be a match. I believe it's October 24th, if I'm not mistaken. It's going to lead up to that big card. Okay. Trying to see when is this big card going to be? Is it October 9th? I think that's the one that we're all kind of rooting for. Yes, that's the big one that we're all kind of waiting for between these two. And of course, you got Mike Bailey, Hiromu Takahashi, Mike Bailey. That's going to be a big one. Okay. You got Tama Tonga versus David Finlay. I mean, it's going to get really important come October 9th. And that I'll be able to watch. So, you know, I'll be able to watch that more or less. I mean, obviously, I'll be in school. I'll be working on October 9th, but I'll watch it right after. I'll do a review. That'll be fun. So we'll talk about that more after. The cards leading up. I might do another review covering this, because this is clearly the most important card that's been led up to. It's finally the big, you know, lumberjack match, IWGP title match. We've been waiting for this for so long. So yeah. But let's focus a little more on this card. We've got the just four guys at the moment versus House of Torture. Again, House of Torture probably needs the win just to kind of keep the momentum, to keep things, you know, to keep things high stakes, keep the tension rising so that Sonata can actually win against Evil. 1-on-1, take the title back, and there we go. 7th match, no limit, no time limit, elimination match. You got LIJ, okay, versus essentially Chaos. And you got Leo Rush in there. This is great. So, we're going to see Okada. Maybe Chaos will win. Maybe LIJ will win this. And why am I saying that? Because I kind of see Leo Rush winning the junior title. So like, it's kind of like giving Hiromu Takahashi the momentum that he needs to kind of look strong going in as he loses to Leo Rush. I think that's what's going to happen, because we have a lot to, you know, think about. So what I'm going to do, guys, is do another review of the October 9th event. I'll do that real quick throughout the week. Get a quick predictions for that show. And that way, as we get closer after we've watched October 7th, we've seen what's going on there. We'll have a clearer view of what we think is going to happen. I mean, I have a lot of good ideas as to what's going to probably happen with that show, as it has kind of been built up, you know, immensely. And I don't think there's going to be too many crazy surprises, but we'll do a little predictions for that card throughout the week before I head out to Pittsburgh. So on that note, you guys have a great evening. Enjoy the rest of your weekend. Enjoy Wrestle Dream and enjoy Road to Destruction October 7th. Once again, y'all take care. And again, at Channel Cortez 33 for Instagram and Twitter. Make sure to hit that like button, and I will see you all later. Take care. Bye.